Thank you very much for joining us, Stormwatch 9 Weather on the Web. Here we are moving into a new month of February tomorrow. And yes, it's going to start off very cold early on your Wednesday morning. Fair skies north, few high clouds central and south, temperatures below zero in northern New Hampshire. However, as we jump ahead into Friday, especially afternoon into Saturday night, some high impact alert weather rolls in the form of a true Arctic blast. It only hangs around for 48 hours, but during that time, dangerously low temperatures and wind chills will be moving in across the state. What does that mean? Well, the wind chills could drop lower than 40 below zero, and under those extreme conditions, frostbite could occur or would occur in a matter of just 5 to 10 minutes. At least for now, much more seasonably cold air moving on in. The true taste of the Arctic chill is well north of the border and nowhere close to the Granite State. So overnight lows tonight, while they're bitterly cold, especially in the northern half of the state, below zero, it'll be slightly above that farther south. High temperatures tomorrow, with sun and clouds mixed and a flurry up north, will be in the 20s, and the wind's not as strong. So these temperatures are very close to the average for the 1st of February. Then by Thursday, temperatures could actually jump slightly above average with a blend of sun and clouds. Now it will be a little bit breezy out of the southwest, and that will provide a wind chill, put that in the upper teens and 20s in many parts of the state. Then here comes that true Arctic chill. Early morning snow showers, especially northern half of the state, they'll begin later Thursday night, but by mid-morning Friday, they're all gone, and it's all about the Arctic chill. 5 north, near 20 south at about 4, 5, 6 a.m., and then temperatures fall all day long into Saturday and Saturday night. So factoring in the wind, by early Friday morning, it'll feel like near or slightly above zero, anywhere from Manchester, point south and east, well below zero already north. But throughout the day, temperatures and wind chills get even lower. The winds themselves could gust over 30 miles per hour, could be a few widely scattered outages. And of course, with this bitter cold in place, that does spell trouble if that does happen. Without that, the winds are still going to put the wind chills anywhere from 20 to 40 below Friday late afternoon, early evening, and later Friday evening through Saturday morning, anywhere from 50 to 35 below zero. And then by Saturday afternoon, those wind chills begin to come up a little bit, but still well below zero if you're planning to do any skiing this weekend. Sunday is certainly your day. Saturday really can't be advised, because you can get frostbite in just a matter of a few minutes if you're out with those extreme wind chills. By Sunday, notice we're above zero temperature-wise and wind chill-wise. So there's some good news. It only hangs around for 48 hours. But again, during that time, it is dangerous to be outside. Sunday, we're back into the 30s. Could be a couple of mixed showers, mainly during the afternoon, anytime in the day far north in the form of flurries. And then temperatures remain slightly above average for Monday and Tuesday.